Welcome to the Scots Church Melbourne's Big Hymn Sing, the first one for 2020. Wherever you are, we hope you enjoy this event. Now, for some years now, we've been conducting a couple of these Big Hymn Sings every year. And normally the pews are pretty full and the singing is so passionate, those wonderful hymns, those beautiful hymns of the Christian church, that sometimes it seems like the very rafters are going to lift. But thanks to the COVID-19 pandemic, this Big Hymn Sing is a little different. This time the pews are empty, but I certainly hope this won't stop you from singing along. And the principals of our choir will be joining us, and they'll be socially distanced, as they should be, as we enjoy these wonderful hymns. With the exception of the two renditions of African American spirituals, all the hymns that we will be singing are taken from the fourth edition of the church hymnary. That's the hymn book that we use here at Scots. And to help you sing along, the words of each hymn will appear on the screen as we go. Now, this is a service of worship, worshipping God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in music and song. So it's fitting that I call you to worship from the opening verses of Psalm 92. Hear the word of God. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to your name, O Most High, to declare your steadfast love in the morning and your faithfulness by night, to the music of the lute and the harp, to the melody of the lyre. For you, O Lord, have made me glad by your work. At the works of your hands, I sing for joy. Amen. And thanks be to God. Our first four hymns are number 152, Praise the Lord, His Glory Show, by Henry Francis Light. It will be followed by 463, Fairest Lord Jesus, translated from the German by Lillian Stevenson and others. Then 551, In Heavenly Love Abiding by Anna Letitia Waring. And finally, in this bracket, 397, In the Cross of Christ I Glory by John Bowring.
Thank you.
African American spirituals came out of the depths of sorrow which marked generations of slavery in America. The yearnings for another life found expression in these old songs. In modern times, their words and melodies have been set by many composers. And one of the finest is Moses Hogan, who died in 2003 at the far too early age of 46. Today we hear two of his arrangements. God's are gonna build up Zion's walls, and a little later we'll hear There is a Balm in Gilead.
Great day, the righteous marching, great day, the righteous marching, great day.
Our next three hymns are 490, Jesus, Lover of My Soul by Charles Wesley, 202, Stand Up and Bless the Lord by James Montgomery, and then 405, We Sing the Praise of Him Who Died by Thomas Kelly. And these will be followed by that second African-American spiritual, There is a Balm in Gilead. Jesus, Lover of My Soul was written by Charles Wesley back in 1738, barely a few months after his conversion. And it was first published as a poem. In fact, it wasn't until 9 years after his death that the hymn tune we know it by was paired with his words. But since then, it's been published in more than 2,600 hymnals. And today's arrangement is a labour of love from the principal of our choir, Vaughan McKelly. Jesus, Lover of My Soul is a hymn used by God to change many lives. And it's even been used literally to save the lives of some. And one example of this was revealed during a reconciliation gathering of veterans from both sides of the American Civil War. An elderly Confederate recalled that late one night, before the war had ended, he was on patrol when he sighted a sentry from the Union side. His rifle aimed with a clear line of vision, he was about to pull the trigger when the Union sentry broke into singing, Jesus, Lover of My Soul, let me to thy bosom fly. The gunman paused and listened. As the Union guard continued to sing, cover my defenseless head with the shadow of thy wing. The soldier just put his gun down and crept away. He said, I couldn't kill that man though he were 10 times my enemy. A Union veteran spoke up. Was that at the Battle of Atlanta in 64? Indeed it was. I was that sentry. The Union veteran explained. He spoke of his fear of battle, the sense of hopelessness that he felt on that night, and the peace and comfort brought to him by the singing of that hymn. With that thought in mind, let us sing together, Jesus, Lover of My Soul.
Oh,
The next three hymns are 462, The King of Love, My Shepherd Is, a paraphrase of the 23rd Psalm by Henry Williams Baker. Then we'll be singing 439, Look Ye Saints, The Sight Is Glorious by Thomas Kelly. And then after that, perhaps the most well-known hymn in the English language, number 555, Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound by John Newton. And after that, Dr. Robin Batterham will play Elegy by George Thalden Ball.
Thank you. Thank you.
Our final hymn is by that most prolific of hymn writers, Charles Wesley. It's Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. And it's been arranged for us by our Scots Church Choir principal, Vaughan McKelly. And so, in closing the big hymn sing from the Scots Church here in Melbourne, I give you this benediction. Go in peace, dear brothers and sisters, wherever you may be, to love and to serve the Lord Jesus Christ. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest on each one of us this day and forevermore. Amen.
We'll do it again if we get.